हेलो लर्नर्स, यू आर वेलकम टू माय चैनल एनबी इंग्लिश ट्यूटोरियल। फ्रेंड्स, इन माय अर्लियर वीडियो आई हैव एलैबोरेटली डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द वेरियस लिटरेरी पीरियड्स विद सम मेजर फिगर ऑफ द एज फॉर योर बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सीन दैट वीडियो, प्लीज़ डू वॉच द वीडियो। यू विल फाइंड द लिंक बिलो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। एंड इन माई प्रेजेंट वीडियो I will talk about the MCQ question answer from a very important age, that is the age of Chaucer. Chaucer, a well-recognized poet, you must have heard this name before. Every year in NET exam, minimum 2 or 3 questions come from Chaucer. Keeping that in mind, I have prepared a list of questions that will help you in your upcoming NET exam. So, without wasting any further time, let's enter into the questions. Question number 1. The age of Chaucer ranges from option 1240 to 1300, 1360 to 1400, 1340 to 1400, 1340 to 1380. The correct answer will be 1340 to 1400. This is the lifespan of Geoffrey Chaucer, who born on 1340 and died on 1400. Next question. Chaucer lived during the reign of Edward II and Henry III, Richard II and Edward III, Henry IV and Richard II, Edward III, Richard II and Henry IV. The correct answer will be Edward III, Richard II and Henry IV. Next, who introduced the heroic couplet in English? Option Pope, Chaucer, Swift, Dr. Johnson. The correct answer is Chaucer. Next, which of the following French romances was translated by Chaucer in English? The Tales of Rome, The Tales of France, The Romance of the Rose, and The Tales of Britain. The correct answer will be The Romance of the Rose. Next, which poem by Chaucer was written on the death of Blanche, the wife of John Gaunt? The options: The Book of Duchess, The House of Fame, The Legend of Good Women, and Troilus and Cressida. The correct answer is The Book of Duchess. Next, which following work of Chaucer is most celebrated on? Roman de la Rose, The Canterbury Tales, The House of Fame, The Book of Duchess. Answer is The Canterbury Tales. This is his masterpiece written in English. Next, in The Canterbury Tales, the pilgrims are going to options: The Shrine of St. John Walter, Shrine of Sir Joseph, Shrine of Thomas Becket, Canterbury Cathedral Homage. Answer is Shrine of Thomas Becket. Next, which is the month that mentioned in the prologue when the pilgrims start their journey? March, April, October, December. The answer is April. In Chaucer work, the month of April is celebrated, whereas in T.S. Eliot's work, The Holoman, the April is the cruelest month. Next, the fictional inn where the pilgrims meet in the Canterbury Tales is Southwark Inn, Princetown Inn, Tabard Inn, none of these. The answer will be Tabard Inn. Next, who is the host of Tabard Inn in Canterbury Tales? Harry Bailey, Potter Bailey, Henry Bailey, Huari Bailey. The options are very confusing. The correct answer will be Harry Bailey. Next, how many characters are there in the prologue? 24, 29, 31, 39. The answer is 29. Next, it is decided that each Canterbury Pilgrims would tell in all how many stories? 1 story, 2 story, 3 story, 4 story. The answer is 4 story, because 2 story is on the going journey and 2 in coming back. Next, the knight is a character of the Canterbury Tales, the Parliament of Fowls, the House of Fame, the Legend of Good Women. The answer is the Canterbury Tales. Next, in which tale of Chaucer, a daughter is killed by her father? Options are The Clerk's Tale, The Monk's Tale, The Friar's Tale, The Physician's Tale. The answer is Physician's Tale. Next, who called the prologue to the Canterbury Tales the prologue to modern fiction? Long, Spencer, Arnold, Pope. The answer is Long. Next, who called Chaucer the father of English poetry? Dryden, Sidney, Pope, Arnold. The answer is Dryden. Next, he found English a dialect and left it a language, said by Lewis, Ward, Mandeville, Albert. The correct answer will be Lewis. Next, the 100-year war began in the year 1348, 1327, 1338, and 1356. The correct answer is 1338. Next, the 100 years war fought between England and Ireland, England and Spain, England and Italy, England and France. The answer is England and France. Next, which of the following was the closest contemporary of Chaucer? Options are William Langland, John Wycliffe, John Barbour, John Gower. The correct answer is William Langland. Next, Langland's Spires and Ploughmen is an elegy, ballad, satire, allegorical poem. The answer is a satire. Spires and Ploughmen is a satire on society, aristocracy, clergy, peasant revolt. The answer will be clergy. Next, who is known as the morning star of Reformation? Spencer, Sidney, Wycliffe, Chaucer. The answer is Wycliffe. Next, who was the first translator of Bible? Wycliffe, Tyndale, King James, Langland. The answer is Wycliffe. Next, John Barbour's Bruce was written in 1378, 1382, 1375, 1390. The answer is 1375. Next, the Peasants' Revolt took place in the year 1338, 1348, 1356, 1381. The answer will be 1381. Next, who says about Chaucer's character, "Here is God's plenty"? Arnold, Dryden, Browning, Dr. Johnson. The answer is Dryden. Next, who among the following is not a Scottish Chaucerian? Robert Henderson, William Dunbar, Gavin Douglas, John Gower. The answer will be John Gower. Next, who said Chaucer's character are individuals as well as type, not mere phantoms of the brain but real human beings? Dryden, Arnold, A.C. Ward, Johnson. The correct answer will be A.C. Ward. Next, and the final one, Chaucer was called the earliest of great moderns and also the morning star of Renaissance. Who initiated these remarks? Hudson, Pope, Albert, Dryden. The correct answer is Albert. So these are some important MCQs from the Age of Chaucer. Hopefully this video will help you, and I will upload more such videos, that is MCQs on other important ages or specific writers. So be in touch with us and keep liking, commenting and subscribing our channel. I see you guys with a new video. Till then, have a good day. Thank you.